Well, good morning, lovely ladies and gentlemen. Steve Collins coming to you from beautiful San Antonio, Texas, the second most powerful, passionate, purposeful coach and speaker in the world. I hope you guys are excited about another lovely day to write the story of your life with the words of your mouth and what you speak. I'd like to have a conversation with you today about something near and dear to my heart, and it is the understanding that there is a huge myth, misconception, and deception that occurs worldwide that has robbed other people for centuries of comfort and peace and hope. Thousands, I would dare to say millions of people have been robbed of comfort, of peace, and of hope because of the majority of people believing one particular lie. And I'm going to expose that lie today. And the lie is this. Here's the lie. Are you ready for the lie that robs other people from peace and joy and hope? Here is the lie. You can't say anything to them to help them out because you ain't even helping yourself out. You can't encourage them because you yourself are discouraged. You can't encourage them in their marriage because your own marriage is going crazy. You can't encourage them in their hard day of parenting because you're not parenting the way you want to. You can't inspire or motivate somebody because you aren't inspired and motivated. That is the lie. The lie is you can't help somebody else until you have helped yourself. Lie, 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 lie. Now, there are specific instances where your experience of, knowledge of, and victory with can certainly add WD-40 to that process, but I will tell you this. In your deepest, darkest days, has anybody ever out there had a deep, dark day? If you had, throw me a couple hearts, because I can't read while I'm driving. I won't read while I'm driving, but I can see some little stuff flying up there. Have you ever had a hard, difficult, or challenging day? Go back to that time when you had a hard, difficult, or challenging day at any time in your life. And let me ask you this question. If one of your friends who is struggling or going through some stuff called you up to say, hey, I just want you to know that I'm thinking about you. I'm praying for you. I've had you on my mind. I know what you're going through, and I just want you to know that I am here for you if you want to talk. I don't have anything to fix for you. I'll listen. I'm here for you. If you want to grab a cup of coffee, or you want to grab lunch or something, or you want me to come to the house, you just let me know and I'm here for you. I'll listen to what you're going through. Would you say on your darkest day, well, I know you have things going on in your life too, so you can't comfort me? Nope. You would not say that. Of course you would not. In fact, you would be relieved, wouldn't you? The truth of the matter is, too many people are believing the lie that they truly can't make a difference in another person's life until they fix up all their own stuff. Ladies and gentlemen, we would not have a Bible of people changing lives if perfection and qualification was the foundational necessity to being used by the good Lord to make a difference in other people's lives. And would you like to hear the fascinating irony of this reality? It is in the very time that you are hurting the most yourself, going through the most pain yourself, struggling with the most stuff yourself. It is in the irony of it is when you're going through that dark season yourself, that is actually the best time to reach out and encourage another person. And let me tell you why. Because of a simple principle. What you focus on expands. For those of you that are old enough to remember cameras of old that people used to use, you used to have a lens, and when you would twist the lens, whatever you focused on made everything else blurry, and you just saw that one thing amplified. What you focus on expands. When you are focused on your own challenges, your own issues, your own struggles, your own problems, you don't realize this, but I'm about to give you a key that's going to liberate you. That is a great time to get out of yourself and encourage another person. Pour into another person. Share with another person. what you need, discover this. This is a quote that I love that comes from a guy who's a coach at a Keller Williams office in San Antonio, Texas, named Steve Collins. This, discover what you want and need from other people. Discover what you want and need from other people, and then give it away. Discover what you want and need from other people, and then give it away. What do you want and need from other people? Do you want respect? Do you want honor? Do you want them to show you attention? Do you want them to not only put their phone on vibrate, but like put it under the table? Do you want people to give you their undivided attention? Do you want people to cause you to feel esteem by encouraging you? Is that what you want? Discover what you want and need, and then give it away. You give it away. You pour it out. My mentor Zig Ziglar would say this: if you go out in the world looking for a friend, you will find they are scarce. And if you go out in the world looking to be a friend, you will find they are everywhere. You see, one of the ironies of life is that we actually get some healing and comfort ourselves when we step out of our imperfection and pain and challenges, and we step into another person's world to encourage them, give them hope, and maybe some peace of mind that tomorrow can be better than today. Please, my friends, I beg of you, do not get caught in the lie that you have to be perfect, that you have to be winning at a 10 in any area of your life to be qualified to encourage another. No, you don't. You just have to be present and care. Be present and care. Now, here's the difference. Offering somebody unsolicited advice out of ego is a different story. I've had so many people tell me, you got 7 kids and you've been married for how long? 24 years. I got to give you some advice on marriage, man. I've been married 7 times. Let me tell you what I know. I'm like, no, bro, I don't know what you know. You've been married. I ain't trying to get married 7 times. I'm just saying, okay? Why don't you tell me what not to do? How about that? You do not have to be winning or at a level 10 in an area of your life to make a huge difference in the life of another person. Let's erase that lie and recognize that, my friend, you have everything inside you that you need today to make a difference in the life of another person today. If you wait until you feel like you got it figured out and all your boxes are checked on your to-do list and you are finally done with the counseling and you are now off the medication and you've gone to all of the seminars and now you are sitting at the top of the mountain going, I'm ready for you now, I'm perfect. Dude, you are going to be waiting for the rest of your life. You ain't never going to help nobody if you're waiting until you're fully fixed up to do it, because you ain't never going to be fixed up. This boy right here is under construction and will be under construction until the day that Jesus calls me home. I will be under construction. There is no finish line in this marathon of life. There is a constant moving toward, and there's no pause, ladies and gentlemen. If you think you're on pause, you're really not. You're either moving onward and upward, or you're moving downward and backward. So let me end with what I began with. The biggest lie on planet Earth that has stolen from and robbed good people of peace, of hope, and of comfort is other people believing the lie that you have to have all your feces consolidated before you can help another person. No, 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 that is a lie. You actually get healing in your heart when you give to another person out of your need. You actually just need to be that person that cares. Nobody cares what you know. Zig Ziglar would say it this way: people do not care how much you know until they know how much you care about them. Do you care? Guess what, baby? You qualified. Do you care? You're qualified. The human spirit and the human heart knows when another soul has compassion and is willing to be a comfort. So I encourage you today, ladies and gentlemen, if you just open up your eyes, stop focusing on your stuff, and look out, look in the eyes of somebody else, be sensitive to what's going on with somebody else, give out of your need to another, and then allow the good Lord himself to come and comfort you in your need. It's called reaping and sowing. It's a principle, and I hope today you choose to make that choice to make somebody's life better. Have a great day, guys.